一体何なんだ。友達だ。
What's going on, YouTube? Welcome back to another FFB War of the Visions video here for update day on Wednesday for the new Diablos update, as well as some other content added to the game. So let's get started of what is new. So first off, we have our shop of the week is going to be the Chapter 8 release shop. So every day you guys are going to be able to get 10 skip tickets. So they are free. They don't cost you gil, they don't cost you visor, nothing like that. So go and pick those up. Other than that, we got the same kind of packs, and I'm not really going to go into these because they're the same thing every time. You have your Vision Card Training Pack A, which gets you some Magicite summons daily, some other Magicite summons daily as well. Then you guys have your 2,000 paid Visor Training Pack. If this is basically meant for if you guys want to get Vision Shards for specific things you were close to maxing out, or you really want to max out for 2,000 paid. So that's going to cost you like 35, 40 bucks, something like that. Have to check what the, I would assume you can use it up to everything prior. It just says you cannot be used on limited or collaborative vision cards. So maybe you can even use them on Diablos, I'm not sure. But I would assume anything previous to Diablos for sure, that's not limited, you guys can use those on. So that gets you 50 shards there. And then you guys are also going to get a Rainbow Vision Sphere, some Gil, and some Growth Eggs to basically somewhat break you even, or at least recuperate a little bit from leveling it up. Then you got your Dark Esper Enhancing Pack, which is just going to be 10 XL Magicites. I would not do that. And then Growth Eggs, definitely don't do that. And then the rest is just the same kind of stuff we always get. Give you the Growth Eggs, it's still not bad, but we've talked about that multiple times, so we're not going to spend a lot of time on that. So for the featured vision card shop, you can get 3 copies of 25 art shards for Diablos, Fleeting Blossom, Growth Egg, and Growth Eggs, like the normal Growth Egg stuff. Here's what I would do, guys. Even if you don't plan on pulling for Diablos and you just want to get a shards down the road, I would wait because this is up for 2 weeks. And I say wait because unless you guys are still working on your consumption bonus for Kilth, if you're looking to possibly cash in on a consumption bonus for next week, then I would wait till patch of next week to see if we get a new hero consumption bonus, or maybe a vision card consumption bonus, or whatever consumption bonus they want to give us. But if you're like pretty far away from that 50,000, that 50k viz, or the 24k viz, or wherever you're at in the consumption bonus, and you're just not going to reach there, even if you guys end up spending an additional, you know, 4,000-ish Vizor here, or 3,700, whatever it is, then I would wait and try to cash in on a consumption bonus for next week. So just a little, kind of like some secret advice from Fort Misery about that kind of stuff. Next, we have Lucia and Adelard are the rate-up featured normal repeat units for this week. So a lot of people have Lucia maxed out by now, and I do, so this shop is complete skip for me. I may just buy some of the stuff for Gil just to stock up on some materials, but outside of that, nothing of relevance to me. And then we have our old featured unit shop, obviously, for Kilth is still here for one more week. So if you guys still wanted to get any of the shards or materials from her shop from last week, it is up for one more week. You guys have time to save up some more resources for that. So those are all the shops we got for the week. The Mog shop did not, I don't think, update at all. There has been some errors and some stuff going on with the raid. So you guys do see the Chocolate Flan raid did come back. I did not get any compensation for that. And I was a freaking idiot. And I let all of my raid coins go to waste from the previous raid. Not the Final Fantasy raid, because we still have all that going on for Final Fantasy 1. But the one before that, I was an idiot, and I forgot to cash in my currency because I was doing my daily buys of my Limit Break and TMR pots. And I was an idiot, and I didn't use them, and so they're probably gone unless they randomly do the same thing and bring back the shop with all the currency that I had saved up, and I can cash those in. If they decide to do that, if there was some kind of error, but more than likely I'm screwed. Feels bad, man, but it is what it is. You know, now I know I need to not do that anymore. Is just calculate how many I need to get daily and then buy everything before, like outside of that, and then buy the recipes of whatever I want to buy beforehand. But it is what it is. So at any rate, hey guys, wanted to throw this in here real fast. I forgot to put this in the video. We are currently looking for 5 members to join our guild. We're currently at Platinum 3, very regular group of people, the 23 members, and no really big requirements, just to log in, do your Guild Wars, donate. Our statues here are at 5444. So if you have any questions, feel free to join the Discord down below. Comment in the video if you guys are interested. And at any rate, let's move on. In the Far Clan for this week, not much at all. This is going to be a very light farm week. So unless you guys are building your staff or your katanas, as far as recipes goes, those are the only things to go after. Me personally, I do not need either. I already have one platinum rod, completely maxed out built, and then I don't have a katana user that I plan on building anytime soon, or even in the near future from what I've seen in JP of what I plan to pull on. So for me, the Far East is a complete skip event. We do have the challenge quest, which there's not actual gear to grind. It's just the first time clear stuff. So if you guys go in here, we look at the things you guys can get. Definitely you do want to do these here. Get your 50 viz for your first initial clear, and then you want to get the 3 rainbow materials. So the rainbow EX cubes, you can use those to try to power level up your units to 99 once you guys get them to 89. Once you TMR them is what I would recommend saving your rainbow cubes for. And then obviously we all know how important the rainbow fragment thoughts and rainbow vision spheres are. So pretty simple. You got to just kill 3 enemies. So you got to bring an AoE unit, you know, someone like a Medina. Sid can do some decent AoEs. I believe even Ramza can do some AoEs as well. So like anything with taunting spell, taunting blade, those are all good skills to use. You know, Lucia even has some AoEs. So there are a lot of different options you guys can use for that. But I think definitely mages are probably some of the higher up ones. Just like they have, like, if you use Blazega with Medina, and then you guys have Sal, can you use Thunderiga? So like different things like that are really good things. Rain is another great unit. His limit break is, I believe, an AoE, or I know he has like Fire Agar or something like that as well. So he's another good unit you guys can bring as well. So it is pretty hard though. Like, this is definitely a challenge content, especially when you guys get into the brutal difficulty of Quest 1. You definitely will have to manual. What I did was I brought my Warrior Blade, my Engelbert. I believe it was Ayaka, Sid, and Medina, and then I brought in, simply because my Kilf is not built up job point-wise to bring her into hard content yet, so I gotta wait probably a couple more weeks before she's really ready, where I can get most of her skills on the 2 classes I'm going to use to like 15 or so, and then that was pretty much how I did that. And then I brought a friend Warrior of Light just for that tanking, building up hate on both 2 of the Warrior Lights. I have my Engelbert on Val Love, so just to draw in all the damage to the 3 tanks, use Ayaka when you need to heal, and then just pick units off with Sid and Medina was my strategy to get the clear. I did have to manual control. I couldn't just let it sit on auto and have them do all that. And I did have to do 2 separate clears. So I did 1 clear to kill 3 enemies simultaneously, and then I did the other 2 clears to do, actually 3 clears. 1 with no KO'd units, and then 1 do not hire a companion. So that's how I did that one. Now for this one, honestly, I would just go for the 50 viz. All this stuff, I don't think anyone uses really items. At least I don't ever use items. I don't know. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe you guys do use items. But honestly, this stuff all appears in the regular shop, I'm pretty sure. So like, I don't know. Like, is it worth the beating your head over to try to do all this stuff? Defeat 4 enemies simultaneously. Clear everything at the same time. Do not hire a companion. No KO'd units. I don't know. If you guys think it's awesome to get those stuff, and like, if it's like a personal goal of yours to like, I want to challenge myself to do it, I totally respect that. And that is, you guys are awesome. But me personally, because I juggle so much gotchas, my business, all this kind of stuff, I just don't have the time to go through and figure out what the best kind of combination is. So me personally, I'm probably not be doing this. I probably will get the 50 viz just as the first time clear. Just to do that. But outside of that, that's probably where I'm going to stop there, just to see how hard it is and test it. But yeah, that's pretty much where I'm at with the challenge quest. So once you guys do what you want and you guys are happy with your results, don't have to worry about it, even though it is up for 2 weeks. Then the only other thing we got added in the limited Far Plane is going to be the secret book quest. Same old stuff. This week, you guys can get katanas. You guys can get your staffs, and then you can get your daggers. So, but if you guys are lacking on any of these seals, very important to pick up these seals. Like magic seals, very good to get. So I want to get up to 50 magic seals eventually when I do build max 5-star awakened reigns weapon, so I can do that. And then I need attack seals always for like everything, because the majority of what I play are attackers. And if you don't need attack seals, then you're going to need magic seals, because you need one or the other. Either you're going to be playing something that uses magic or something that plays attack. So it's a good thing to have like at least 50 of each on hand so that you can immediately build up a weapon. Do not take anyone else's RNG advice. Always level your plus fives, 5-star, with seals. Don't ever do the thing that some people say on YouTube to do, is just use all your Reesmith hammers and don't use seals. I'm telling you from my personal experience of wasting over 20 Reesmith hammers, it is not in your favor that you are going to roll well without seals. I'm just going to say that now. I'm going to leave it alone. And you guys can flame me in the comments if you think I'm wrong. But from my personal RNG experience, I ain't leveling up anything plus 5-star without seals. That's just how it goes for me. I'll wait till the secret book quest comes where I can get them. All right. And then we actually do have to go to the daily training because they did update this. So, yeah, guys, we do have the yellow and pink material separated into two categories for two levels for yellow and pink. And then we have them into three categories for the ABC. So you guys see here. We go into here, and then we're going to have a total of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, looks like 8 and 9 for A for the specific job yellow materials to get. And then let's see if it's 9 here as well. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, it looks like, if I'm counting right, for B. And then for C, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 for C. And then it will be pretty much the same thing when you guys go to your pink materials. But what is cool, on top of getting the 50 viz, which I recommend you guys wait until Saturday to do this, because even if you're just going to do your initial one clear each on these, and you don't really need the pink materials or the yellow materials right now, definitely do these just to get the Nameless Hero icon, because that basically gives you a guaranteed of 3 of any type of the job-specific symbol materials you want for the pinks. The yellows is not really super important to get it. I mean, I think you guys should still get it just because I'm pretty sure you get a Nameless Yellow, right? Yeah, you get a Nameless Yellow as well. I mean, the yellow is pretty easy to get because they appear in all this, because you can get them in like all the different yellows throughout throughout the chapter's main story. But the pinks are super important to get those Nameless Heroes. They are very expensive to use for friendship points and guild points. So definitely, guys, pick those up if you guys are working on anything that's a TMR unit where you need those pink materials. So very, very good to get those. So let's hop into story. I wanted to finish story to like maximize on my 5 daily clears, but you know what changed my mind this week, guys, was that, believe it or not, finally in story, we got some useful things added for drops in regular story in the new chapter. And what it was is this stuff. So look at this. The black spirit sand is now a droppable material that we can get any day of the week we want in regular story. And it's going to be like that for several other materials. So on Leaving a Mark here, guys, you guys can get the cloudy sap. So that's very cool. Or the clear sap, sorry. As well as the blue fluid. Then you guys also have job materials and statues as well for different of the elemental types. We go here, and here we go, my boy, Blissful Hearts. Who needs Blissful Hearts for their Armor of Lights, for their Venera weapons, so on and so forth? A very, very coveted item that I was using constant Warrior of Light event exchange currency on to get. Believe it or not, I never really had that much problem with recipes. Like, I think I cashed in maybe for like 30 recipes total. But Blissful Hearts was what always was holding me back from building my 2 complete plus 5 Armor of Lights for Barrier and Shield. So the fact that we can grind this any day of the week, any day we want, is fantastic. That is phenomenal. So if you go through all these different stages, you guys are going to see just you're going to have all these different crafting materials of the ones that are like of the gold rarity that we normally could only get from certain EX events. So like once the event was over, you had to wait for the event to come back. But now in story, if it's not the recipes you need, It's just the materials and story, you can get them. That's fantastic. At least for some of them. So I'm not sure if all of the purple, like the crystallis material or whatever they're called, like the purple alchemist, the blue alchemist and things like that, if all those are going to be in story. They may not be. I can't remember if they are in story. It didn't look like they were in any of these chapters. So those still may be limited, but at least the hearts and like the cloudy saps and the clear saps and the spirit sands and things like that, those are now available in story, which is phenomenal. That's very, very good. So shout out to Gumi for doing that for us. So let's go into the mission tab to look at the missions that we still have access to. So you guys have your story part one. You guys can get 25 prisms, fragment of thoughts for your ice, fire, and wind. And then you can get 500 Vizora when you complete through stage 10. Then we go into our event tab. There is a little bit of events, even though we didn't really get anything new. In the secret book quest, they have refreshed the rewards once again. So you can get 10 of each fragment of thought, 10 of each prism. And then you guys can get 2 seals of each of the ones that are featured here and 300 Vizora for the regular 5 clears. So you just got to clear this 5 times. Super easy content. Anyone that's been playing for at least a month or two, you guys should be able to auto this, no problem. Then on our co-op, we have some more stuff to get as well. So looks like that's going to be 5 seals of each, as well as 5 of the books. But we have an arrow here, don't we? So it looks like 5 books of each. Yeah, it overflowed. There was too much. And then 100 Vizora. So you will get 400 Vizora for doing this. So that's pretty good. We're getting definitely over 1,000 Vizora this week from the new content to be able to clear that. So that's very, very strong. And then what is it? The consumption bonus for me, I am at 29,000. So I am definitely not going to be able to get to 50,000. More than likely, there is 1 week left on it. We'll see what happens. But I'm pretty sure I'm not going to be able to get there for this. But we'll see. I'd have to spend another 20,000 Vizora to get 20 shards for free of Kilth, which probably won't happen. But that is everything with the shops, that is everything with the missions and the new events. So let's talk about the banners real quick before we end the video for the weekly update. So we have our featured banner with our new pity system, all that's going on. You get the August medals, all that. Look at the drop rates real quick for our boy Diabolos. Real fast, so he has, so the all the heroes are a 0.10% drop rate, then 0.4 for the MRs, so, or I'm sorry, 0.4, okay, oh, those are SRs, that's why, okay, all right, I was like, what, all right, and then we have a 0.8% drop rate for, obviously, the 2 new UR prints, which is Diabolos and Blossom Banquet. So nothing strange there, but what they did do is another bait and switch is what they're trying to do for you guys, is they want you to spend 10,000 Vizora to guarantee you guys will get Diabolos. So guaranteed on step 5, you will get a copy of this. Where was this system when Odin came out, man? Oh my god, of how much Vizora I would have saved. Or money. I guess I wouldn't have wailed like that if I would have gotten guaranteed in 10,000 viz. But how much money I would have saved if this was out during Odin's release. So I guess this will be hopefully in everything with the new Espers going forward, that if you have 10,000 viz, you're guaranteed to get one copy, which is pretty awesome. I'm definitely down overall. Me personally, I'm still not pulling though, because this is still so close, like I've said, to the 6-month anniversary, and instead of using 10,000 regular Vizor, I'm just going to use 2,000 paid and select him to get him, assuming I don't pull him off banner and anything else that possibly might come up, like a half off banner or something like that. If I randomly get him, then obviously I won't have to use it, but yeah, that's my goal. So I'm personally going to skip on this banner, on this step up for this week. But if you guys are really looking to add him to your roster for your Kilth, or for your Sal or your Medina, anything like that, he's phenomenal to use on any of those heroes. So definitely, if you guys are looking for that, and he's a very good meta counter to the heavy light meta that we have with things like Ramza, Warrior of Light, Engelbert, things like that, he's very good because he's got a light eater ability as well in his grid. So super, super good. If you guys, super good value if you guys are able to do that, because at least you guarantee. And basically, this is actually better than the pity system, because technically you get a guaranteed UR at 5 multis as opposed to 6 multis. So, yeah, pretty cool. I'm pretty down. And then you guys do have your Vision card, 2,000 guaranteed AUR. I definitely would not do that, though. So, yeah, that's the banner. So, pretty cool. I'm actually really excited. They did add some quality of life, some stuff to this. Doing some more stuff with the summon banners, making summon banners a little bit better. And then, obviously, helping out the training chambers is really nice. And the story materials this time in Chapter 8 are actually very, very good and very, very helpful to the community for people building the MR tier weapons. So let me know what you guys thought of the update today in the comment section down below, guys. If you guys did enjoy today's video, make sure you guys drop a like down below. Hit subscribe if you guys are new to the channel and ring that bell so you guys do not miss the next episode here of War of the Visions here on Fort Missouri Gaming Global. And we'll see you all in the next video. Be safe, wash your hands, wear your mask, all that good stuff. And we'll see you all next time. Later, guys. Hey, guys, wanted to throw this in here real fast. I forgot to put this in the video. We are currently looking for 5 members to join our guild. We're currently at Platinum 3. Very regular group of people, the 23 members, and no really big requirements, just to log in, do your Guild Wars, donate. Our statues here are at 5444. So if you have any questions, feel free to join the Discord down below. Comment in the video if you guys are interested, and back to the video.